Hi, my name is Yash Mittal and I am working on the Netlify design. So I'll just share the update that what has happened and what I'm currently doing. So, you know, I am picking up the issues on which there's a label of need design. And yeah, Sean has told me that, you know, instead of redesigning the whole Netlify website, we can, you know, start from the based on the issues. That way it will help to close the issue, and also we can step by step redesign the whole Netlify CMS. So this is just a simple logo, and I have, you know, created the two different pages. So first is the component and second is the pages. I will start with the components, and this is the just the colors. I thought these three are the primary color, and these are different colors I'm thinking to use, but still I'm not sure which one to use. And if you have any suggestions, not only to the colors but to the overall design and everything, you are open to contribute. And I'm currently using Figma. I will just paste the link in the description of this video so that you can access this video and the Figma file also and contribute back. So this is all for the color. So these are the primary colors of the Figma UI, and these are the colors which I'm thinking to use, like the arrow colors and the text field colors. And next is the atoms. So what I meant by this atom thing, that for the design purpose, I have divided the design into atomic design concept. You can just search on the Google atomic design. So that concept I am using over here, and I had divided into five sections. First is the atom, molecules, organism, and rest of the two is on the other page. So the other two are templates and pages. So first of all, in the atoms, we have icons. As I have told you that this whole design is, you know, just my concept or my thoughts that how it should look. Since, you know, Netlify CMS is an open source project and everyone has contributed, so same goes for the design also. You are open to contribute to this design, and if you have any suggestions. So that's why found out a few these icons and which one are best to use. I found one this on the internet, and I changed to this one, and I'm now using this one in the text field. I will just show you recently. And this is the menu button, and this is for arranging the text. For example, you know, we got a list of blog posts, and in that case maybe we want to, you know, rearrange the way the list is rendered. Maybe we want it to ascending or descending, or maybe we want it to be date wise or according to the name. So in those cases, this is helpful. And this is a check mark, as obvious, and this is a search bar. And next is the buttons. So regarding the buttons, these three are just the simple buttons which are currently being used in the Netlify UI. And I haven't thought about it, that how it should look for the new design. But regarding this, I have just added a bit of this separate section for this drop down, where it could reflect that we are clicking on the drop down list. And these are the three new buttons I have created. This one, as I have said, for this icon, it is for rearranging the list of entries. And these two I'll discuss later on. So I'll just tell you just the brief concept. So what it is, for example, maybe in future, Netlify CMS implement the feature where we can add new widgets or fields directly from the UI. So in that case, these buttons will be helpful. And I in one of the widget, I have used this buttons also. So the design is look, the design looks good. Yeah. And the next is the field widget. So it is just a simple, I have just created a bunch of different variation that how it should look. And this is just a simple field, and the field with the heading and the hinted text. And this is the again the next field with some text, and another field with some text and some restricted value. And here's the alternate option where, you know, if a user exceeds the value and go beyond 250 words or whatever the limit, the whatever limit has been set, then we can show negative value. And apart from that, we can even show some kind of an error. So we can show error below over here. So regarding this error component, I want to say that there was a issue on the GitHub that that the error message go beyond the size, and it get so when the, you know, the size get the size of the text get out of the page, so it get hidden. So that's why I redesigned the field widget. And over here now, the lines, as you can see, we get multi-line error or the single line error. And this is all about the text and the text field. And this is about the description. For example, we want to add the description to a specific field or the widget. So in that case, this is helpful. So I have to currently design the search the search component. Basically, the search component you can see in the home page, where you can see where you see the list of collections. Above that, there is a search. So I will be modifying that, or you can say redesigning the search option. And next is the molecules. So molecules are, so molecules are the combination of atoms. And over here you can see this is a drop down which we'll be using at different places. For this drop down, we'll be using at the when we are editing a post. In that case, we can use this component. And for example, when we are ready with the post which we are editing, and now for example you want to publish that post, sorry, so that, so this is the molecule section over here. This is the drop down in which I have created different types of drop down list. This drop down, well, it is, you know, not used it anywhere yet, though. So I have taken the reference from the user who has, you know, posted a similar design in the comments of the issues. So I have taken from that and created the design. And this is for the, so this is, this will be used when, for example, when we get a list of you know, post. In that case, for example, we want to open that post, or maybe we want to edit it also, or maybe we want to duplicate it or delete it. And next is the next is this drop down. This drop down will be used when we are on the edit page of the post over there. Of course, we want to, once we are finished with the editing, we want to publish it, or maybe we want to duplicate that. And next thing is about this drop down. So as I have mentioned earlier regarding the arranging the text, so this drop down will be used where so it has two sections. As you can see over here, I have created a divider. So over here, so this is the, you know, if you want to change the order, we can do it ascending or descending. For example, we choose descending. Now we want to select on what basis we want to, you know, organize the content. Maybe we want to organize by title, slug, date, or date created. But this may be changed. It is, you know, just a content that how we want to organize the content. And next is this another drop down. So this drop down is currently not being used anywhere, or it is even the issue is not being created. And so I thought, you know, I was, you know, when I was designing stuff, I thought that it is helpful, and that's why I have created this drop down where, for example, it is possible that we are, for example, editing a post, and in that we get an editorial workflow. Over there, we basically get three sections. First is the draft, second is in review, and third is, I think, maybe I don't remember it. I think it is pending or published, I don't know. So whatever what this drop down is for, maybe it is not possible that currently, I think editorial function feature is not available in the GitLab and the Bitbucket. So in that case, this can be used where we can just select click on the menu. I'll just show you. I have designed it over here. So this is, I will just explain this in more detail later on. So what I meant by that for example, we get an entry, we can click on the menu button, and where we will get maybe something like this or whatever, you just get it, that what I'm trying to say, that we can change the status directly from the list of entries where we get. We can, you know, maybe set as published, or maybe we can disable that specific entry, or maybe, so these are, this can be changed. So these entries are specifically for state, for changing the state status. And these can be, you know, use it anywhere, that this can be used for widgets. For example, you want to maybe disable a widget, or maybe we want to disable or unpublish a specific post. So in that case, it is helpful. So regarding this, I just want to say a last thing, that I haven't created the issue or discussed about this in the with the team of Netlify CMS. So I have to tell them also. And this is the section widget. I have just completed the design recently. And what happens, for example, we maybe use a list widget. In that, maybe we get for example, what should I say? Yeah, for example, we get for example, as you can see, this is the section widget, right? So in that, maybe we have a bunch of different lists. Excuse me. And that's why this section is very helpful, that maybe, you know, this is the when the widget is closed. So this will be the design. When the widget is open, then this will be the design. Or maybe we want to, you know, delete that specific widget from the view. So we have the cross, we have the move option where we can drag around the widget, and then the collapse in or collapse out. Now, as I mentioned about the, you know, status of this thing, so this is what I meant, that we can change the status. I have, you know, read the issue where for example, we if we do not set a value of specific widget, so in that case some kind of a problem shows up, or that entry doesn't exist in the code itself. So that's why you know, we can disable it, or maybe we can enable it later on, as we prefer. And these are the just two different design. The layout is same. Over here we have some kind of a background, and here we have the white background with the border. And as I was telling, you know, that we have a, in the section we have a different list. So that case, this will be used. And I will just show you that how we can use this thing in just a moment. And this will be the view for the post entry. So currently what happens, only we see the title of the post, and with the just a blank white bar. Now what I have added, we have added an avatar. So what's my plan over here is that we can, you know, fetch the avatar from the Git repository, that who is for example that I am, you know, making some changes to the Git repository, or I have, you know, made some changes to this specific blog post. So my avatar will show up, or maybe later on maybe some other person has collaborated on this specific post, then his avatar will be also show up. Or maybe you know, I don't know, this feature may be useless also. So what my point is that regarding the fetching of the, you know, user's information. We can fetch all the data from the GitHub, I suppose, or maybe just from the Git repository, or if the user is using that what it's called Git identity, I'm not sure, it is a Netlify's product, so we can use that thing also for just fetching the user's data. And this is the menu bar where we can modify a specific entry. If we click on this, we get just a bunch of entries. Maybe we want to open the post, or maybe we want to edit the post, or maybe we want to duplicate or delete it. And next is the organism. Over here, you can get a better look of what I'm trying to say, or maybe, for example, we have different components, right? So we, when we join the component, how it will look. So that's why it is all about, you know, the atomic design. For example, first we were looking at the atoms, then molecules, now organisms. In the organism, so if we join the different atoms, we get this drop down where when I told you that, you know, if we are on the edit page, we will get some kind of this thing where we click on the drop down, we may get this layout depending on the position of the button. And same goes for the for that item, as I told you over here, the entry. For example, in this scenario, maybe we get and drop down around over here, or maybe we can get a drop down below the entry. That depends on how we want, you know, show the drop down, and it should not also cover some other part of the content. So this is just the basic of content, that how we, when we join the component, how does it look. So nothing fancy over here, but here comes the awesome part. And I have just recently, you know, created the whole design and replied to the Sean regarding the design, that how do you like the design. By the way, Sean is the lead developer on the Netlify CMS team. Okay, so over here is a lot of thing to tell. I will just you know, try to keep it brief. And so most of this thing I have already told you in this above section over here. So as I have told you about the design, that this is the molecules, and I have joined the molecules and created the organism. And this is the section. Maybe we have just a bigger section, and inside that maybe we have a bunch of list items, right? And inside that list we have maybe more widgets. We got a string widget, we got a date picker, anything it could be, and just a different variation of that same layout. And over here we get another variation. Maybe we get an error in the widget, so in that case we want to show the error also. And and there was another issue in which currently what happens in the current design of the Netlify CMS, we always have to scroll to the top and click on that new plus icon to add a new entry to the list. So that's maybe we get maybe 20 or 50 or maybe hundreds of list items. So in that case, it's a bit hard to scroll above and below. So that's why what happens, we are just, it's obvious that we are working from top to bottom. And in that case, I have added the, you know, a plus icon. It's not an icon, it's just an element we can add below. So as I was talking that earlier about the buttons, so we are using it over here. So this is just a this part requires a bit of animations, or maybe, I don't know, I don't think so. Netlify is using much of animations currently, but what I meant over here is that that the user will see all this content. But this content will be not be accessible until and unless he clicks on this button. And once he click, this new item will be added to the list. And then this component will appear over here, like if you want to add a new element or not. So this is the motto what I'm trying to say. And yeah, so this is all for the organism. Now let's go for the templates. So there's nothing much about the, you know, the templates. There's a lot of work to do in the, you know, templates and pages. But I can show you what I'm trying to do over here. This is still work in progress and it's quite messy over here. So what we have currently in the, if you see the overall page, so earlier we was looking at the specific components of the whole UI. Now I'm talking about the just the overall page. Currently we have the header horizontally on the top, but I'm planning to move it to the left vertically. So the plan for moving it to vertically is that maybe we want to add more options, like maybe we can add an option as dashboard, then we can add an option for maybe assets, editorial workflow, we can add an option for like settings, images, media uploader. It could be anything, and so that's why you know, it will be there will be less space for if we stick to the header in the top. That's why it is important we should move to the vertical part. If this is the minified version, I am planning to add maybe where we can, you know, compress and expand the sidebar. So that's the plan, but it's, I'm still working on it. I don't like that design what I have done currently. And this is the there was another issue where we want to share an update regarding the Netlify CMS. When there is a new release, a bunch of maybe a few people only check the releases, that what are the new updates or bug fixes. So that's why I have added this widget where for example, when we get a new notification, the user can click on this and this widget should pop up where he can just get an overview of what are the change logs of the Netlify CMS. And if he wants to read the specific change log, he can click on the change log and then he can he will move to the Netlify CMS website where he can read the whole change log. So this way, I know that this way is not very much good, but what I'm trying to say is that we are, you know, not filling up with a lot of information, and just we want to give a glimpse of the Netlify CMS change log, that what are the improvements for the security changes, optimizations, or new thing or bug fixes. So that if the, for example, maybe I'm not interested in bug fixes only. So that's why we get an we are showing an overview of each and every change log, and according to the user, he can read the specific change log he wants to. So that's why it's just a widget where we can redirect the user to the specific change log, and he or she can read the full change log. Okay, so that's all I have got. And yeah, last, I just want to, you know, thank to all the references. So what's the plan is that whenever, you know, I found some reference from the people who share their images on the GitHub issues, maybe they post some reference that the design should look like this. So in that case, I have pasted all the references images and the design which I have completed, so that I have removed. But these are the entries which I'm currently working on. So big thanks to all of them who have shared the reference that how the design should look. And last but not least is that if you are interested in, you know, contributing to the design, you are most welcome. Yeah, so that's all I have got for this update, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.